Hi, it's Miss Pascaline. Welcome to my kitchen. Today on our menu, we have oven grilled chicken. And this is so easy, but gives a very great result. If you're new here, thank you so much. Please don't forget to subscribe and then like. So we are serving our grilled chicken with jollof rice. You can serve your chicken with anything you feel like, white or plain rice, veggies or salad, potatoes, anything you want to eat your chicken with. This chicken, just look at the inside. It's so moist inside and it's tasty to the bone. And the outside is crispy. I mean, it's not the kind of real chicken that you take and the inside doesn't have taste, but the outside is so nice. So please stick to the end, and I bet you'd really enjoy when you use this recipe. So for our ingredients, we have chicken. We are using drumstick and the whole thigh. So you wash your chicken very well. Make sure you get all the extra feathers off. Set it aside. Make sure you've drained all the water and paper towel dry it. So we use lemon, half lemon. We use garlic. I'm using about 7. Ginger, onion, just a small onion. I'm using Maggi cube. I'm using the chicken Maggi cube. I have black pepper. I have anise, coriander there. And this is thyme and habanero pepper. With the pepper, take it according to how hot you want your chicken, how spicy you want it. We use extra virgin olive oil. You use just 1 tablespoon. I love adobo, the all seasoning. It makes your chicken comes out so tasteful. And then we use paprika. This is the smoked paprika. And it's already in the powdered form. Salt to taste. We'll be using about 1.5 teaspoon of salt. As for the salt, when you use it, just make sure you've tasted to make sure it's on point. So we grind our ingredients and then we add the powder, the powdered ingredients to it. When you grind it, just add the olive oil and just a little water so you have a thick paste. You add your lemon to it. You squeeze about 1 tablespoon of lemon and you squeeze the whole or the rest of the lemon onto the chicken. Make sure you cover your chicken well with the marinade you've done. Cover everywhere, and then if there's excess, just go ahead and pour it. For a great taste, you need to marinate your chicken for at least 2 hours, or you can keep it in the fridge overnight. So this one I'm keeping in the fridge overnight. When you bring it out, just allow it to settle and the temperature comes back to normal room temperature. You go ahead, you line your grill, and then you arrange your chicken nicely onto your grill. After that, use a brush to make sure you've evenly spread the marinade onto your chicken so that the end result will be great. Always preheat your oven, and then I will want to keep it on the oven side for about 15 minutes before I change it to grill. This helps the chicken absorbs the marinade so well. So we'll go ahead and prepare our barbecue sauce. For barbecue sauce, we use brown sugar. I don't like so much sugar. I don't want my chicken so sweet, so I'm using just a teaspoonful and then a tablespoon of ketchup, tomato ketchup. I'm using dark soy. I'm using just a spoonful. I'm adding black pepper. I really like a lot of pepper. I'm adding black pepper, and then you stir, and I added just a little of water, about a teaspoonful. This is because I don't want my barbecue sauce so thick. So after you've changed your oven settings to grill 15 minutes on each side, then you go ahead and wash or you smear your barbecue sauce onto your chicken. This is a bit light because I don't want it so thick on my chicken. But if you want it so thick, skip the water so that as you spread your barbecue sauce onto your chicken, it's so thick. But this is the perfect texture I want. I don't want it so covered. So grill your chicken, check on it frequently to make sure it's perfectly grilled. And the aroma that will come from your chicken is just, I mean, you would always want to use this recipe. You would love it. Thank you so much. Let me have a feedback. Don't forget to subscribe and give me a thumbs up. Bye. Love you. Till we meet again.